हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट फ्रेजनल बाइप्रिज्म। द एक्शन ऑफ द बाइप्रिज्म इज टू प्रोड्यूस टू कोहेरेंट इमेजेस ऑफ ए गिवन स्लिट Where are separated at a certain distance and becomes and behaves as two coherent sources. Fresnel used the bi-prism to show the phenomena of interference. Bi-prism is a certainly a combination of two acute prism placed base to base as shown in figure. In fact, this combination is obtained from a optically plain glass plate by proper grinding and polishing. The obtuse angle of the prism is about 179 degree and the other angles are about 30 minutes each as shown in figure. The acute angle is 179 degree and the both corner angle are 30 minutes each as shown in figure. To show the phenomena of interference, a horizontal section of the prism is shown in figure as follows. The two emergent waves, the two emergent wave fronts are derived from the same wave front by using Fresnel bi-prism. Hence, the fundamental condition of the interference is satisfied. S1 and S2 serves as coherent sources. The interference fringes are obtained in the overlapping region EF and can be seen by eyepiece as shown in figure. Now, measurement of 2D. 2D is the distance between two virtual sources, the separation of two virtual sources. It is very important because without 2D we are not able to find out the wavelength of light used. To determine 2D, the distance between two point sources can be measured by using two methods. First is deviation method and second is displacement method. Now we will discuss about deviation method. When the refracting angle of bi-prism is small, then deviation delta is produced in a ray given by as shown in figure. Where mu is the refractive index of the material of prism and alpha is the refracting angle. So from figure D equal to del A, okay, and del equal to D by A. The separation between the two virtual sources 2D equal to 2 del A, equation number 1. Now, del equal to mu minus 1 alpha, equation number 2. So, from equation 1 and 2, we can find out 2D equal to 2A mu minus 1 alpha, where mu is the, as we have discussed above, refractive index of the material. Now, where alpha is in radian. Therefore, increasing the angle of bi-prism, the distance between two virtual sources increases. In case of bi-prism, the fringe width is reduced so that fringes will not be visible separately and ultimately disappear by increasing the angle of bi-prism. Now, we will discuss about displacement method. In this method, a lens with focal length less than 1/4 of the distance between bi-prism and eyepiece is mounted bi-prism and eyepiece as shown in figure. The lens is adjusted in the two positions L1 and L2 till sharp images of sources S1 and S2 are obtained in the field of view of the telescope or eyepiece. You can say that eyepiece, sorry, as shown in figure. The distance D1 and D2 between the two real images in the two sources can be measured by using magnification formula for lens from figure for the position of lens L1. We have D1 upon 2D equal to B upon U, equation number 1, and similarly for position of lens L2, we get D2 upon 2D U upon B, equation number 2. From equation 1 and 2, we get 2D equal to under root D1 D2. It is the desired result which we are going to obtain by using displacement method. The distance or separation between the two virtual sources S1 and S2, which can be measured by using displacement method. Now, we will discuss about the next topic, displacement of fringes and determination of thickness of a thin sheet of transparent material. Okay, as we have discussed above, the interference of two interfering rays, we will find out the resultant intensity. Now, which is very simple, suppose that as shown in figure, we have a single source of light, we have two slits, and the single wavefront is splitted into two wavefronts. If we put a thin sheet of mica or transparent material in one of the two interfering rays, then what happened? Now we will discuss. When the sheet of transparent material such as glass, mica, etc. of thickness T or of refractive index mu is introduced in the path of one of the interfering beam as shown in figure, the entire fringe system is displaced through a constant distance toward the path of the beam in which the sheet is introduced. Now consider the path S1P. The length S1P minus T of this path is traveled in the air with velocity of light c, while the length T is traveled in the mica with velocity cg. The time taken by light to cover this distance is given by S1P minus T upon c plus T by cg. We know that c upon cg equal to mu. Refractive index formula you know better. Now cg equal to c upon mu. Hence the time taken from the S1 to P is given by S1P minus T upon c plus mu T by c, which can be written as S1P minus T plus mu T by c. No, sorry, let us get S1P plus T common. Let us take common T, mu minus 1 by c. Now the path difference, the path S1 to P is equidistant to an air path S1P mu minus 1 into T. Now the path difference at point P, path S2P in air minus path S1P, okay, the total path. So path difference can be represented by this notation. Path difference is equal to S2P minus S1P plus mu minus 1 into T. Okay, सो एस टू पी माइनस एस वन पी माइनस म्यू माइनस वन इंटू टी। नाउ पाथ डिफरेंस इक्वल टू टू एक्स डी अपॉन कैपिटल डी माइनस म्यू माइनस वन इंटू टी एज वी हैव ऑब्टेन्ड द वैल्यू ऑफ टू एक्स डी एस वन वैल्यू ऑफ एस टू पी फ्रॉम फिगर अबव फिगर टू एक्स डी माइनस टू एक्स डी अपॉन डी माइनस म्यू माइनस वन इंटू टी इक्वल टू एन लैम्डा वेयर एन इक्वल टू जीरो वन टू थ्री फोर टू एक्स एन डी अपॉन डी माइनस म्यू माइनस वन इंटू टी इक्वल टू एन लैम्डा फॉर मैक्सिमा दिस इज द कंडीशन फॉर मैक्सिमा सो टू एक्स एन डी अपॉन कैपिटल डी इक्वल टू एन लैम्डा प्लस म्यू माइनस वन इंटू टी एक्स एन इक्वल टू एन लैम्डा प्लस म्यू माइनस वन इंटू टी इंटू कैपिटल डी अपॉन टू डी सो वी गेट एक्स एन इक्वल टू डी अपॉन टू डी एन लैम्डा प्लस म्यू माइनस वन इंटू टी इट इज इक्वेशन नंबर वन इन द एबसेंस ऑफ द प्लेट मीन्स इफ यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू पुट द प्लेट इन द पाथ ऑफ एनी वन इंटरफेरिंग रेज सो थिकनेस बिकम टू जीरो वी गेट टी इक्वल टू जीरो वी गेट एक्स एन इक्वल टू डी एन लैम्डा अपॉन टू डी इक्वेशन नंबर टू नाउ फॉर एनथ मैक्सिमा वी कैन फाइंड आउट टू एक्स डी अपॉन डी माइनस म्यू माइनस वन इंटू टी इक्वल टू एन प्लस वन लैम्डा बाई टू नाउ टू एक्स एन प्लस वन फॉर एनथ के लिए हो वी हैव डन फॉर एनथ नाउ वी आर फाइंड आउट फॉर एन प्लस वन मैक्सिमा 2xn plus 1d upon capital D minus mu minus 1 into t equal to n plus 1 lambda by 2. It becomes xn plus 1 equal to xn plus 1 equal to n plus 1 lambda by 2 plus mu minus 1 t. We have common d upon capital 2d. If yes, capital S denote the displacement of nth maxima by introducing the mica seat, then s equal to d upon capital 2d capital d upon 2d n lambda plus mu minus 1 into t minus d n lambda upon 2d solve it you get the desired result s equal to d capital d upon 2d mu minus 1 into t equation number 4 equation 4 is the independent of 1 as shown in equation the question 4 is independent of n hence the displacement of each maxima is the same now we find out the fringe width beta equal to sn plus 1 minus sn so you have the value of sn plus 1 and sn put the value and solve it you get beta equal to d lambda upon 2d So the presence of the plate does not change the fringe width. Means the fringe width of the interference pattern does not changes by introducing thin sheet of mica or glass or transparent material in the path of one of two interfering rays. Means the fringe width is same for all. The entire fringe system is shifted by yes toward the side in which the this thin sheet is introduced without any change in fringe width thickness of the mica sheet by above equation we can easily find out the thickness of mica sheet as we have s equal to capital D upon 2d mu minus 1 into t so we get t equal to 2xd upon capital D into mu minus 1 It is very important because you get the numerical on this equation. Let us solve some numericals on the above equations. Now, suppose that for example, 20 fringes are displaced when a thin glass plate is introduced in one of the path of the interfering beams. Find the thickness of its given that mu equal to 1.5 and wavelength equal to 6000 angstrom you have the formula as we know that mu minus 1 into t equal to n lambda t equal to n lambda upon mu minus 1 put the values you have the values
सॉल्व इट एंड यू गेट द रिजल्ट t इक्वल टू 2.4 इंटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 3 सेंटीमीटर. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल. व्हेन ए थिन सीट ऑफ ट्रांसपेरेंट मटेरियल ऑफ थिकनेस t इक्वल टू 6.32 इंटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 4 सेंटीमीटर इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन द पाथ ऑफ वन ऑफ द इंटरफेरिंग बीम्स कॉजिंग इंटरफेरेंस द सेंट्रल ब्राइट फ्रिंज शिफ्ट टू ए पोजिशन ऑक्यूपाइड बाई सिक्स ब्राइट फ्रिंज फाइंड रिफ्रेक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ द सीट गिवन दैट वेवलेंथ इक्वल टू 5460 एंगस्ट्रॉम. वेरी गुड सोल्यूशन. गिवन दैट एस टू पी माइनस एस वन पी इक्वल टू जीरो सो वी गेट म्यू माइनस वन इंटू टी इक्वल टू एन लैम्डा. हियर you are going to find out the value of mu refractive index. So refractive index equal to n lambda upon t plus 1. Put the value, you get the desired result mu equal to 1.5. refractive index equal to 1.515. this is the desired result for above example. It is all about displacement of fringes.